watched her now for the last 12 weeks, and I think her arms are just playing better than ever, and I think she'll probably walk away with it.
The risk of being accused of being a male chauvinist, I think Mr. Riggs will win. I think perhaps I'm being colored by nostalgia, but I also think that the man has tremendous experience, and the male muscle is always a little stronger than the female muscle.
I don't think he's any match for someone of Margaret's stature. I think Margaret's playing the best tennis of her life, and I think Bobby Riggs is living on his past. He's 55 years old and, you know, wears glasses, and I'd be surprised if he wouldn't have a coronary right there. But I really, truly believe that Margaret will win the match.
Country Estates, the CBS Sports Spectacular presents The Big Challenge, Margaret Court versus Bobby Riggs. Sponsored by Ford, who invite you to see all the better ideas for 73 at your Ford dealers.
Beautiful service.
Game.
That was her best shot so far.
Happy Mother's Day.
In one all, second set.
I know my mother in Cincinnati is watching this match, and her only complaint is I don't get on camera.
Look it up there, Tony Trebich. You better send someone to get their tickets. I think they're sneaking a view up there from the mountainside here, the Cuyamaca Mountains.
One of the nice things about this event is that the Diabetes Association of Southern California has gotten the money, the gate receipts. They charge $10 a seat, and the place is packed, so we're delighted for that.
How many does it hold, Tony?
Oh, about 3,000.
And I might add, you just finished putting up the grandstand about 10 o'clock this morning.
That's why we couldn't get the road done.
Doc Kearns is out there with the satchel, ready to go.
I think that's one of the few errors that Bobby's made in the whole match.
You know, at this point, I'm a little disappointed that Margaret has not changed her style of game. You don't lose a set 6-2 and be down 4-1 and still stay back. If that's what you've been doing from the start, you've got to change the losing game, and she has not done it so far.
She did for that one game, Tony, and then she didn't stick with it.
Do you think maybe, Tony, that her confidence is pretty low at this point?
But she's lost her confidence by staying back and being beaten. Why not change it? Notice Bobby stands quite a ways behind the baseline to return serve because he wants a little more time to get that racket ready because she does hit the serve pretty hard. Margaret serving, having lost the first set 2-6, and she's down 1-4, and it's 30 all. And her first serve has deserted her.
Thank you.
set up and missed it, and now it is break point.
38-40.
And I think when you get in a situation that Margaret's in now, you really try to go for too good a shot, don't you, Tony?
She's pressing, I'm sure. Boy, if she loses this point, she is really just about all out of it.
That's out.
She missed it. Outside. Game, Mr. Riggs. He leads 5 games to 1.
5 games.
Second set.
Right at the start and throughout, I've said that I felt Bobby Riggs would figure a way to win. I thought it would be a close, perhaps three-set match. And I have also said that if there is a quick match, Margaret would win quickly because I thought she could steamroll it. And that showed you how much I know about tennis.
It's
like being up against the ropes.
Zet made that call. She's a San Diego housewife.
It
wasn't that close.
Riggs serving a 30-15. He is 2 points away from a devastating win.
Well, it was his mouth that created this match. Now his wits getting very close to victory.
Now it's a break point. If Margaret can get this point, she will start to get back in the match. It would make it 5-2 in favor of Riggs. Riggs takes a peek at the scoreboard. Could serve a double fault here. Backhand down the line, misses by about a foot, and she dejectedly walks back to return serve at deuce. Coming up for Margaret Court, fighting hard to stay in this match.
Score is deuce.
Just when you think, Nancy, that she might turn the corner,
right,
something happens to change
her mind. And he throws in that big serve. I keep hoping that she'll follow his second serve to the net.
Does this mean that all the mothers are going to have to cook their dinner rather than be taken out tonight?
I don't know. I was hoping you'd take me out.
Advantage, Mrs. Court. Again, a point break. Here it comes in slow motion. Margaret returns the backhand. Bobby comes up, tries to drop out. Now we're back live. Outside.
Margaret just missed with that, so it's deuce again.
You really have to give Riggs credit. As you said earlier, every time she gets close to getting into the match, he does something unexpected. He came to the net that time and forced an error.
We are at match point.
Advantage, Mr. Riggs. I'm really dumbfounded. I had no idea that he could do this to her.
$10,000, winner take all, is on the line, and that 55-year-old hustler's going after him. Yay! Welcome back at dinner.
Score is deuce.
The women are back in.
He has not cashed that check just yet.
Grant, Bobby put up $5,000 of his own money, so if he wins, he gets his $5 back, plus he earns $5. If Margaret wins, she gets $10.
Sure, that was Bobby's own money.
Yes, absolutely.
He didn't go win that someplace. He didn't take you out on the golf course or anything, did he?
No way.
Somebody may be in backgammon.
Again, it's a break point for Margaret Court.
Seventh game of the second set.
And if Margaret's getting some advice on the sidelines, I don't think it's too good advice, because that was a perfect second serve to try to hit and come in behind it.
Just outside, call made by Jane Mead.
Let's see if she goes in behind this return.
That almost looks like nerves to me when you really don't hit out on the ball, you know? She has such a great forehand.
Match point. There it is. Bobby Riggs wins 6-2.
Yes, match.
6-1. Riggs. Unbelievable.
6-2. 6-1.
Thank you, Lyman.
Bobby Riggs has done exactly what he said he would do. He would